Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be doing something different in that today we're going to be talking about tech news from the last week till now. And this is going to be a thing, like a custom, if you will, on the channel. And I'm actually going to be doing this every Thursday, and I'm going to be talking about the prevalent and the most fascinating news from the previous week just till that point in time. And if this sounds like something you love and you're new on the channel, definitely consider subscribing. And without further ado, let's get right into it. The first topic for today is Reddit co-founder resigns, asked to be replaced by black candidate. Alexis Ohanian, co-founder of Reddit on June 5, announced he's resigning from the platform's board to dedicate his time and money to serve the black community, chiefly to curb racial hate. He made this known via his Twitter official page. With the Black Lives Matter movements and protests becoming a matter of global significance, several individuals and firms have been stating their support for this, including Reddit. In his tweet, he asked to be replaced by a black candidate. He also mentioned that one of the reasons he's stepping down is because of his daughter, Alexis Ohanian Jr. Finally, he mentioned that one of the reasons he co-founded Reddit was to create a sense of belonging and community. Google faces $5 billion lawsuit over tracking users, even in incognito mode. As it stands, Google is facing a $5 billion... As it stands, Google is facing a $5 billion class action lawsuit over tracking users of Chrome, of course, in incognito mode, despite claiming privacy while using incognito mode. The lawsuit was filed in the federal court in San Jose, California. Wait, is that San Jose or San Jose? I remember I called it San Jose for a couple years straight. Anyways, in San Jose, California, on Tuesday, 2nd June 2020, and he accuses the company of collecting the data of people while using incognito mode, despite claiming that incognito mode is totally private. The suit also alleges that the company's gathering of data through Google Analytics, Google App Manager, and some other apps allows the company gather enough information about the users, more than they would really like to share, and about the pages they visit, private pages even in incognito mode, and just their habits online, which can be somewhat embarrassing because, of course, why would you use incognito mode in the first place, right? The complaint seeks compensation of $5,000 for the violation of federal wiretapping for the millions of people in California who have used incognito mode since June 1st, 2016. I mean, that's like 4 years already. Wow, that is a lot of data. I mean, that is a lot of money for Google. Google is rich. Google, however, responded through its spokesperson, Jose Castaneda. Wait. Why is there a lot of Jose's? Am I the only one that is noticing that? That is already two Jose's, right? However, Google responded through its spokesperson, Jose Castaneda, that the company has every intention of defending itself in court. So we'll see in court.
But I'm not in California.
I promise you, this next one is going to interest you. Apple begs Escobar for extension on $2.6 billion. Escobar denies. $2.6 billion legal saga between Roberto de Jesus Escobar Gaviria. Oh my god, there's so many weird names today. And Apple. Of course, if you don't know Escobar, Escobar is the brother of notorious drug kingpin Pablo Escobar. So Escobar actually sued Apple for breach of security under some counts, I think negligence, negligent misrepresentation, emotional negligence. That was the first time I was hearing of that. Anyways, they sued Apple and he demanded $2.6 billion compensation as the reward for the damages he suffered, because the iPhone S was advertised as the most secured phone on the market. And he actually obviously failed in his hands due to some events that span out, and it actually led him to go into hiding. And now he's claiming that he endangered his life and is suing Apple for a breach of contract. Apple has responded to Escobar's lawsuit requesting a 30-day extension, but the CEO of Escobar Inc., which is the company that has been taking orders and has not been sending the phones out, I hope you have not been a victim of that. It is so pathetic. Anyways, the CEO of this company, Olof Gustafsson, oh my god, has responded that courts in the United States actually allow for 30 days only to respond to a lawsuit, after which the failure of the defendant to respond is going to result in an automatic loss and a win for them. So in this case, they believe that they are going to win the case due to the extension that Apple is seeking. So we will have to hear from the spokesperson of Apple to confirm the updated details of this case, and I will definitely keep you guys abreast as the situation proceeds. Hopefully Apple wins, because I use an Apple phone. Google searches for insomnia and I can't sleep. It's an all-time high during lockdown. It looks like the coronavirus has upset the sleeping routine of a lot of people around the world, as Google Trends have revealed that the Google searches for insomnia and I can't sleep, or can't sleep, just the sleep there. Fuck. The light is gone. That's pathetic. Anyways, as searches for insomnia and can't sleep hit an all-time high during the lockdown. Although there has not been a specific or precise pointer to the cause of this surge in the searches, it can be calculated that this actually happened in April according to Google Trends. And of course, it makes sense that it will be caused by the lockdown. Researchers said just last month, Harvard researchers actually, have said that the coronavirus could upset sleeping routines, which could lead to further mental conditions and aggravated mental issues. So please, if you're not sleeping properly, try to sleep. As for me, I find that these days, as soon as it's 9:30, 10 p.m. and the fan is blowing me, oh my god, I am not sly anymore. I'm drifting already. So please try to sleep more, sleep less during the day. That's what I do. Sleep less during the day, and you should be able to sleep more during the night. Stop playing at night. It's nothing you're looking for. Wow. So for the biggest one, the biggest news I think for today is how COVID-19 contact tracing works on your phone. Yes, you saw it right, you heard it right, and I'm very sure, don't worry, you were already thinking, oh god, this guy clickbaited me. Is there something like clickbaited? Anyways, how COVID-19 contact tracing works on your phone. Developers are working on track and trace systems to keep infection levels low. So this could mean that these apps could help humanity push the coronavirus pandemic out of planet Earth faster. Of course, down the line you would see why we need public approval and cooperation, because now Google and Apple are two different companies that have two different operating systems, and they don't work together on so many projects. They rarely work together, but on this project it was so important that they had to work together. So here is what they did. They did not actually create a specific app or apps. What they did was they made app programming interface, also known as API, that's like a plugin. Alright, so you could call it a plugin. It's just like a foundation for the basic apps that will be used for contact tracing to plug into to let this feature work. So Google and Apple actually made this feature available on both platforms. So I'm sitting here and I'm wondering what is gonna happen to Huawei users, especially the recent ones. I don't even what is going to happen to them. Are they going to just all die of coronavirus? Sorry, I'm joking. Yes, your smartphone, yes, the one in your hands, can be the one to save your life from the coronavirus very soon. Now quickly, here is how to find these settings on your phone. Simply, Apple and Google have done the groundwork, or you can call it the framework or the foundation, making it easier and possible that these two different operating systems can communicate effectively and seamlessly with each other. I believe that is the most important reason they had to work together. So it does not matter if the person that you're actually meeting on the street, or it does not need two phones of the same operating system to work. It could be an iPhone and any Android phone that's powered by Google or running on, you know, Android OS. One more thing is Bluetooth signals is a very, very crucial part of this process. Why Bluetooth signals? Because Bluetooth signals emit low energy, or they don't really emit so much high frequencies, and they don't consume so much battery. They're not very very battery draining. So Bluetooth is actually what is going to be used to connect and do all the range testing and everything these apps that are going to plug into these foundations need to work with each other. And yes, they can actually, Bluetooth can work in the background of your phone without disturbing any activities and draining your battery excessively. In this case, your phone will be logging other phones it comes in contact with, or just say individuals. So if you're okay, here's the thing, if you actually pass an individual on the street just briefly, your phone will probably ignore that information. So your phone is actually just going to be logging phones that you are actually pretty close with or spend some time or a lot of time with. So it's going to be logging the other phones, but for this to work, both phones, I mean your phone and the other person's phone, has to be running this feature and have a COVID-19 contact tracing app enabled and working fully for it to work. So here is why I said public cooperation and support will be highly needed. So if you don't have that, there is no way it's going to work. So these logs don't include any identifying information about yourself or your private details. All it just includes is numerical codes and numbers to be able to figure out the distances and every other thing it needs to calculate. That is definitely not your private information. Also, another good thing about it is even the numerical codes will be trashed completely once it's older than 14 days, because 14 days is the incubation period for the coronavirus. Based on findings so far, the apps will be able to log the amount of time you spent in contact with another phone or another person. Of course, the person owns the phone, so with the other person. Judging from the Bluetooth signals between both devices, it's actually going to be able to calculate the distance you kept from the person, judging on the strength of the Bluetooth signals that is being emitted from the other device or devices, whichever case it might be. And as I said earlier, any contact that is less risky, such as briefly passing somebody on the street, is actually going to be ignored, and the more potentially harmful ones or the more important ones will actually be concentrated on. As a matter of fact, there are very few tracking apps available right now, but Apple and Google have actually finished the processes that they need to make in the respective operating systems, and these settings are now live. So let's start from Android, because I really love you guys that use Android. You guys, this is Android, this is iOS. So you guys are in my heart. What stays on this part of the chest? Quickly, besides the settings that you find in the future apps that will actually run this feature, you can actually disable this feature completely from your operating system level. You can disable exposure notification settings. That is what it is called. So it is a completely opt-in system. It is not something that is forced. If you for some reason don't want to opt into this system or this feature, you can actually turn it off, even if it's accidentally on, which I really doubt. On Android, open settings, then tap Google and COVID-19 exposure notifications. You'll be met with a lot of information on how exposure tracking works, plus two other settings that won't be active until you install a compatible app. One to delete all the random IDs that your phone has collected, and one to turn off the feature completely. For iOS users, open settings like so, select privacy, health, and COVID-19 exposure login. Again, you can turn this login on or off and read some more information about how it works. To get rid of the random IDs that are stored on your phone, tap the delete exposure log option at the bottom. Now, if along the line, unfortunately, you report yourself as positive for the coronavirus, the app will send a record of your rotating ID to a server, and from the server, everybody that has been in contact with you in the last 14 days is going to be pinged an alert to get themselves checked. So either self-isolating or going for an actual COVID-19 test. So when you actually report yourself as positive, again, this will not happen automatically. It's actually going to take you tapping on whatever settings it is to report yourself as positive. So definitely public cooperation needed there too. Then everybody that has been in contact with you that has been recorded on the app is actually going to be pinged or notified of that. Now, one very good thing about this is we're speculating that your name or your identity is actually not going to be revealed while it is sent to every other person or every other phone that this person actually has the coronavirus. Another very important and cool feature about this is you will not just be able to click now positive for the virus, send a ping to everybody I've been in contact with in the last 14 days. No, actually it's going to take a little bit more than that, so some sort of verification from probably medical personnel or just something to safe proof what you're saying, so it will not just be something you can just click and it will assume that you're actually positive for it. So there's going to be some sort of verification that you would have to add to make sure that you're actually genuinely positive for the coronavirus, and then the ping will be sent out to people you've been in close contact with in the last 14 days. Wow. Now that is all the news I have for you today, and I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you enjoyed this video and found it informative, please definitely drop me a like down below. Go to the comment section, tell me something I need to improve on, tell me something I need to add next week, tell me something you thought I was going to talk about, tell me something I did not talk about, I probably didn't hear of it. And yes, recommendations, critiques, and all of that. I really, really would love to be in the comment section with you guys. And if you still haven't subscribed, please definitely consider subscribing, because then you'll be part of the family and it's actually going to encourage me to push out more videos, because I'm going to be pushing out videos like this weekly and as much as I can. You guys should stay safe out there. I'll catch you guys in the next video.